Hello out there. Peabody and Sherman here. How would you like a trip to the mountains, Sherman?
The Rockies, Mr. Peabody?
No, the Andes, to a tiny village high atop those lofty peaks called Cusco.
Who lived there?
The Incas, a tribe of noble Indians who ruled Peru centuries ago. Set the Wayback Machine for the year 1532, and we shall be eyewitnesses when the Incas are conquered by that noted explorer and soldier, Francisco Pizarro. We enter the Wayback, and we're immediately hurtled back through time and space. In 1532, Cusco was nothing more than a small village, and a seemingly deserted village at that.
Where is everyone?
Before I could answer, we were ringed in by a cage of spears.
Make one false move and you goners.
One moment, Chief. I believe you're mistaking us for someone else.
You're not Pizarro.
Right, I'm not Pizarro.
Little boy Pizarro?
No, I'm Sherman.
Then you must be Pizarro.
I'm your wife.
We were taken inside the Chief's hut and given a tall, refreshing glass of llama milk. I must say, Chief, I'm quite surprised to see you only have 100 or 200 men in Cusco.
Most of Incas have gone to India.
India? Incas, Mr. Peabody?
Drink your milk, Sherman.
We hear them rumor that Francisco Pizarro is on way up here to conquer us.
I'm afraid you're right, Chief. It's in history that way.
Well, we got him planned for Pizarro. When he get him here, we're gonna let him have it.
But you can't. According to history books, Pizarro conquered you.
Then we make him liar out of books.
We gotta warn Mr. Pizarro, Mr. Peabody.
I heartily agree, my boy. Well, it was the custom of the Incas to dally away their afternoons playing mahjong, and while they were so occupied, Sherman and I took the opportunity of leaving. We were almost out of the village when who should appear but Francisco Pizarro and two lieutenants.
In the name of His Majesty, I claim this village as mine.
What you gonna name this place, Francisco?
I gonna name it after me. Let me see. The soil here is sandy. That's it. I gonna call it Sandy Francisco.
Crazy.
Senor Pizarro, I don't know whether you're aware of this or not, but 200 Incas are waiting to ambush you.
Oh, don't be silly. Most of the Incas are over in India. And if this little boy make that bad gag again, I'm gonna throw him over the cliff.
Try as I may, I couldn't convince the great explorer that he was walking into a trap. In fact, you can imagine my consternation when Pizarro and his men suddenly curled up in the very heart of the city.
It's time for a nap.
Well, naturally, the Mahjong tournament had to break up sometime, and...
Oh, my gosh! Here comes the chief and his men!
It was too late to awaken Pizarro, so we did the next best thing. We disguised him.
What is it you got there?
These are llamas.
I never see llamas like that before.
Well, these are from Tibet. They're high llamas.
These look like llamas to you?
Not to me.
Me neither.
What they look like to you?
Donkeys.
Unfortunately, Pizarro was a man who required very little sleep, for he chose that moment to crawl out from under the skins.
It is donkey.
No, it is a man.
In the name of His Majesty, you are all under arrest.
Well, needless to say, this didn't meet with the chief's approval. It wasn't long before Pizarro, his men, and Sherman and I were facing a firing squad of spear throwers.
You can't do this to me. I am only an observer from the UN.
You are Pizarro, and you and your fellow conquerors shall perish.
Golly, Mr. Peabody, they're going to throw spears at us.
You mean they'll try to throw them, Sherman?
Spear throwers, get ready. Get set. Aim! Fire!
With all their might, the firing squad tossed their spears. However, halfway to the targets, the spear suddenly slowed to a slow drift and practically crept toward us.
It's magic!
No, atmosphere. You see, up here at 20,000 feet, things don't behave in a general manner, and those spears lose all their resiliency at this altitude. Here they come now. It was a simple task to catch the spears and send them back where they came from. Of course, even though they returned just as slowly as they came, they nonetheless managed to pin each and every Inca facing us, including the chief.
We give them up! You conquer us!
Well, that did it, Mr. Peabody. Now maybe everyone can live in peace together.
Only time will decide that. Oh, my, this is a glorious view up here.
I'll say, the Andes are really something to see.
Some of those mountains just across the way, Sherman. Those are called the Amos Mountains. They're brothers to the Andes.
I never heard of them.
You never heard of the Amos and Andes?